we already know when a force is acting in the horizontal direction and a displacement is in the same direction, then work done W is equal to F into S. When a force is acting in a horizontal direction and a displacement is also in the horizontal direction, either in the direction of force or in the opposite direction, the work done is equal to F into S. Isn't it? Now we are going to discuss when a force is applied at an angle with the horizontal direction. For example, when we throw a stone, we will apply the force at an angle. Isn't it? Then after moving in upper direction, it falls down. Isn't it? So it reached on the surface of the earth or on the ground. Isn't it? So here force is acting at an angle, but the displacement is AB. That means in the horizontal direction. Okay, so here we can see the force and displacement makes an angle. Force and displacement makes an angle, isn't it? So here we can mark like this. Here the force is in this direction at an angle and displacement is in the horizontal direction. So this force and displacement makes an angle theta. It is marked as theta. So the force is acting in this direction. So the whole force is not acting or using for the displacement in the horizontal direction. This force is actually divided into two components. One is in the vertical direction, another one is in the horizontal direction. So this force divided into two, and one part is acting in the horizontal direction, another one is acting in the vertical direction. Okay, so we have to find how much force is acting in the horizontal direction or how much force is used for the displacement in the horizontal direction. So for that, we have to construct a parallelogram like this. Okay, so we can mark here it is A and then B. Now produce BZ downwards perpendicular to this horizontal direction. And then BD perpendicular to the vertical direction. Okay, so this is BD and BC. Is it clear? So now, based on this angle, this is the adjacent side. Because near to this angle, this is adjacent side. This side is opposite side. This side is opposite to this angle, so opposite side. And this angle is 90 degree. This angle is 90 degree because BC is perpendicular to AC. Is it clear? So this angle is 90 degree. So this triangle is a right angle triangle. Okay, this angle is a right angle triangle. So here AB represents the hypotenuse, AC adjacent side based on this angle. And this BC is opposite side, that is based on this angle, this BC is opposite side. Okay. Now in trigonometry, the ratio, that means sine theta is equal to the ratio of opposite side by hypotenuse. Sine theta means based on this angle, sine theta is equal to opposite side by hypotenuse. So here, opposite side means BC. BC by AB. Hypotenuse means AB. So AB is F. So we can write BC by F. Sin theta is equal to BC by F. So we have to find how much is BC. So BC is equal to F into sin theta, because sin theta is equal to BC by F. So BC is equal to F into sin theta. Okay. So this BC is equal to AD. BC is equal to AD. So we can write BC equal to AD is equal to F sin theta. Is it clear? So F sin theta is acting in the vertical direction. F sin theta is acting in the vertical direction. So that is the component of force acting in the vertical direction. Now, cos theta is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse. Cos theta is equal to adjacent side by hypotenuse. So we can write adjacent side means AZ by AB. AZ by AB. So we will get AC by AB. That is equal to AC by F. AB means force F. So we can write AC is equal to F cos theta. AC is equal to F into cos theta. So F cos theta. So F cos theta is acting in the horizontal direction. Okay, F sin theta acting in the vertical direction. F cos theta is acting in the horizontal direction. So F cos theta produces the displacement in the horizontal direction. F sin theta has no influence on the object to make any displacement. So here F cos theta is acting in the horizontal direction. Is it clear? So we can write F cos theta is in the horizontal direction and F sin theta acting in the vertical direction. So F cos theta produces displacement in the horizontal direction. F sin theta has no influence on the object because it didn't produce any displacement in the horizontal direction or vertical direction. Is it clear? Therefore, we can write work done is equal to F cos theta into S. That means F S cos theta. So W is equal to F S cos theta. Okay. Now, theta or the angle may be 0 degree, 180 degree or 90 degree. 0 degree, 180 degree or 90 degree. So, work done W is equal to Fs cos theta and theta may be 0 degree, 180 degree or 90 degree. Suppose if force is acting in the horizontal direction and the displacement is also in the same direction. Force is acting in the horizontal direction and displacement is also in the same direction. Then the angle between them will be 0 degree. So in that case W is equal to Fs cos 0. But cos 0 is equal to 1. So, we can write Fs into 1. So, it will be Fs. So, positive work done. So, when force and displacement are in the same direction, an angle between them is 0. So, we can write Fs cos 0. Cos 0 is equal to 1. So, we will get Fs. That means positive work done. Okay. But if force is acting in the horizontal direction, that means in the forward direction, and displacement is in the opposite direction, then what is the angle between force and displacement? Here it will be 180 degree. So we can write W is equal to Fs cos 180. But cos 180 is equal to negative 1. So we can write Fs into minus 1. So, you will get F negative Fs. Okay, so here work done is negative. We already studied that when force and displacement are in the opposite direction, work done is negative. So, here force and displacement are in the opposite direction. So, angle between them is 180 degree. In trigonometry, the ratio of, the ratio cos 180 is negative 1. So, Fs into negative 1. So, negative Fs. Okay. Now, when the force and displacement are perpendicular to each other, so if force is acting in the upward direction and displacement is in the horizontal direction, then the angle between them is 90 degree, isn't it? So here, you already studied in the case of circular motion, force is acting towards center and displacement is along the tangent. So the angle between force and displacement is 90 degree. So we can write W is equal to Fs cos 90. So, but in the case of trigonometry, the cos 90 is equal to 0. cos 90 is equal to 0. So, you will get W is equal to Fs into 0. So, 0 work done. So, when force is acting perpendicular to the displacement, then the angle between them is 90 degree, cos 90 is equal to 0, so work done is also 0. So we already discussed when force and displacement are perpendicular to each other, the work done is zero. Okay, so when a force is acting at an angle, the equation is W is equal to Fs cos theta. Theta may be 0, 180 or 90 degree. In all other cases, we have to find the value of cos that angle. Cos 45, cos 30, if any other angle, we have to find the value that is given in the table. Okay, so now we are not discussing that cases. So we are only discussing at 0 degree, 180 degree and 90 degree. That means in the same direction, in opposite direction and at the right angles to each other. Okay, is it clear?